Sometimes all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Daily rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you. Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
Rolling! Wakey-wakey, eggs and bacon!
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. Those skeevy assholes. That girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? Smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes. As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night. Max made me this mix CD years ago.
Terrible news, my fellow
Oregonians. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated.
Is shutting its doors. Might have something to do with all the health and safety violations they've suffered this year. We've had a near-death experience here.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong. And it was awesome. I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation that doubles as a middle finger to Ethel. Can't leave without my vitamins. I really should get going. Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town. Wait, what? Who? What photo?
7.9 FM, the Seder, is supported by listeners like you. So, feel free to donate money if you want to. Anytime. Literally any amount. We'll take it.
I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. That really was Rachel Amber. and she saved my life. How was last night even real? Better living through chemistry. I'm perfectly capable of waking up without you, you know. Eventually. Wake and bake is part of a healthy breakfast. Yeah, no one needs to see that. Thank you. Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear. God was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair. Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid, but then all the unicorns died. No more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking rainbows. Words of wisdom, don't fail me now. Just ask Steve Jobs. Adapt or die. Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child. Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay, Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left.
Home sweet home.
Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to. Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair's his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray. The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay. Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pond. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring? Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup. I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad. You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like that. I made this for Mom when I was, like, 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed. I should call my phone. How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Ah, Mom. Bad enough that David comes here for dinner.
Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign. Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech. Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. Better.
I want Mom to be happy, but not like this.
Not like this!
It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money. You should take that down to Mom.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry. Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
Go put my purse on the table before you forget. Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then? Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah.
I used to think drugs were lame too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Firewalk? Is that the band you mentioned last week?
I'm still bummed you wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that—
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? And I do know what pot smells like, you know. Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Never again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe I just need to be left alone.
Maybe you're 16 and don't know what you need. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Your boyfriend's an asshole!
He's been good for me. Maybe he rubs you the wrong way because you've been rude.
He's still breathing. That means I've been more than fair.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such—
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too.
But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
Come on, sweetheart. I'm sure David's waiting for his keys.
Wow. Sean Prescott's son Nathan goes to my school. Sounds like the apple didn't fall far from the asshole. Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
Little dude's like, what the hell just happened? Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
Here they are.
Let's get these to David so he can drive away. No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with... It's my job to water these plants, but... It was Dad's job to remind me, so... No, but...
We're already supporting one. Thanks.
Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never happened. I would have gotten this bad boy in my room.
Hard to believe I was an 8th grade science athlete. Did I peak in middle school?
Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one. From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me. Or it's because we can't afford nice things.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max?
And never looked back? Any letter from Blackwell is never good.
Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year.
How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth?
Come on, sweetheart. I'm sure David's waiting for his keys.
It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
I actually have to let this jack-off drive me to school. This is my life now. Kill.
What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us.
No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with.